First of all, I just hope you guys are better than last night's crowd. I actually had a guy come up to me after the show and ask if I was a registered sex offender. Are you kidding me? God, no. I haven't voted in years. Hello, everybody. My name is Derek, and I'm a pessimist. I don't know, I'm bad with change and assume the worst. Like, if I get kicked out of my place, I just assume I'm gonna end up homeless. Or if I lose my job, again, I assume I'm gonna end up homeless. And if things get really bad and I have to move in with mom, ugh, that's the worst. She is homeless. Ha ha ha. Here's a little advice for you. Never date a borderline anorexic. Man, it's a lot of work. My friends and family always want me to do more to hell. But what more can I possibly do? I mean, I already spent entire days calling her a fat ass. Yeah. Back row. I'll take it. Want to know what sucks? Having your girlfriend ask if you think she may have a personality disorder. Yeah, that just happened to me. And I couldn't avoid the question, so I had to lie to her. Because there's no easy way to tell someone that they have no personality. I'm still with her, though. Seriously, that's just how smoking hot this chick's daughter is. My girlfriend loved to go shoe shopping. I mean, to the point that it became a real problem. So I sat her down and told her, look, you're out of control and need to get some help. She actually listened to me for once, too, and got her some serious help. Yeah, she went out and found her one of those, rich boyfriends. It's a dig, come on. I don't care what people think of me, I have always hated people from the Middle East. And especially Kentucky. And for those of you that don't believe me, yeah, that joke was geographically correct. You guys have all heard of Botox, right? The drug you inject into wrinkles to paralyze them? Next joke, it's no good. I could do that. Hey, is it considered cheating if I'm having sex with someone that has multiple personalities? Wow, oh, man. Either way, I should probably tell them all, huh? But which personality do I tell first, Nicole or Paul? So I got caught stealing pills from my girlfriend. Yeah, she actually counts them, so there's some 25 missing. When she asked if I took them, I lied and said no. Then she looked me dead in the eye and asked me to choose between her and those 25 pills. Well, I did the right thing, and of course I chose her. She has so many horrible shoulder surgeries coming up that she's going to end up being like a Percocet gold mine. America's going bankrupt because of this war on drugs. This war that has the prison industry booming while we absurdly lock up America's youth, enough is enough. We need to legalize drugs, tax the slum at them, shut these prisons down, and even bankrupt inner city gangs while we're at it. And the best part? By taxing drugs. Even politicians will be forced to pay some taxes. This message paid for by people without a prescription for Percocet. Oh, no druggies here, obviously. The drug thing's not all good. One problem with the rise of medical marijuana dispensaries is that more and more dogs are being seen in veterinary clinics with marijuana toxicity. Now, these are serious emergencies that usually end tragically. In only 1 in 50 cases is the ingested marijuana still smokable. So I'm in huge trouble with my girlfriend. Yeah, all I did was tell her that I had another dream about her. What's wrong with having a dream about your girlfriend? But no, she's got to go and get all wigged out just because she never survives. Hey, has this ever happened to you guys? Sometimes I'll be driving around with a dead body in the trunk of my car. And suddenly I'll get this really bad feeling. Yeah, it really freaks me out. At least until I calm down, think rationally, and then realize that it's just, my conscience. Oh, come on, you guys. I could never be a serial killer. Not with my commitment issues. Duct tape, ski mask, blindfold, and a stolen van. These are things you should have way before setting up your Match.com account. So my biggest fear actually came true. This chick accused me of forcing myself on her in a church. And they would have convicted me too had not a countless string of character witnesses come forward to shed a little light on the truth. Because anyone that knows the real me knows that I would never set foot in a church. All right. People that are lonely just need to try harder. I mean, whenever I get lonely, I just step up my game and get creative to pick up chicks. Like just last week when I was really craving some warmth and companionship, I simply drove over to the airport and held up a sign that said, Smith. I mean, once you get them in the car, they're practically yours. My next door neighbor's dog used to bark incessantly. Then out of nowhere, just quit barking. So I went over to check to make sure it was okay. Turns out he got it one of those citronella collars, and the dog stopped barking immediately. Well, I was so impressed, I went out and got one the very next day. I mean, why wait until Valentine's Day? Trust is such a big issue with the relationship. I always trust my girlfriend. Now, she said she's out partying with her girlfriends all night. Yeah, I'm gonna believe her. I mean, instead of worrying and imagining her doing the nasty with some pig of a guy, I just sit back, relax, and occasionally check the tracker I put in her car. Alright, I'm gonna close on this one. You guys better back me on this. I hate when my girlfriend asks what I'm thinking. Yeah, it always catches me off guard. Last time she asked me that, I just blurted out, I was thinking just how different our lives would be if your kids were dead. Yeah, I know, she took that the wrong way. So then I got all defensive and said, no, not in a creepy way, but in a Christian way, like during the Crusades. Well, believe it or not, that little discussion got me into the Guinness Book of World Records under the category of greatest distance ever specified in a restraining order. Thanks, you guys.
Yeah, he'd have made a good honorary Fishmaster, too. Oh, he doing his fish?
Derek killing the wall, everybody. It is Lavois, right? It is Lavois, right? Lavois. Our last comedian of the night is Nicholas, also known as